The defect life cycle or a bug life cycle. So any defects which start with a defect status new, whenever a tester or anybody logs a defect, then it will be opened with a new status. Your test lead or any person who are senior in the team, you will be validating all the information and checks for whether this is a very valid defects or not. Once that confirmation is done by your test lead, then you would be assigning that defects to somebody to the development team. So that defect will be moved into the assigned status. So during assigned status, where developers will be validating all the information, if they find that this is not the right defect, then they will mark the defect into a rejected status. Or sometime if it is a really genuine defect, but they cannot fix it in the current release, then they will defer to the future releases. Let's assume that the defect is really genuine issues and that required to be fixed. Then once the developer mark that defects as a fix, developer will be assigning that defects into ready for retest. Then the tester will be picking the ready for retest defects and you'll be taking a new build and you'll be testing the defects are bugs. In case defect is fixed and it is really working, then tester will be marking that defects into the closed status. In case the defect which is fixed, which is not really working, means then it will be reopened, where developer team will work again on a particular defect until that issue has been either fixed or it will get deferred into the future releases. So this is all about the defect life cycle of a bug or a defect.